Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here, and today I am very lucky to be joined by Steve Dotto. How are you, Steve?
I'm just great, Francesco. Thrilled to be with you.
Yeah, I'm excited. I think the last time we talked, it was talking about the future of Evernote, which was quite fun. Well, the last time we talked about Evernote.
Yes, in public, yes.
Yeah.
Which they've turned the corner. They've done a good job of kind of getting the train back on the tracks.
Yeah, definitely. I think a lot of the behind the scenes videos have helped people sort of get a bit more understanding of what's coming. So
a little more transparency is a good idea, and also understanding the path they're on. Yeah. So it's, well, we had a big decision point on our channel. We were we were on the horns of dilemma of whether or not we were going to refresh our flagship course, our Evernote Made Easy course, and we chose to do that as a team, and it was because of the, you know, because they seem to have their house in order now. So that's good. It's exciting for us all, and a relief, because so many of us have so much invested in Evernote that making a change from it is scary.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, like 8 years plus worth of data. It's mad, isn't it?
Yes. Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah. And before we move on to some of the things you love about Evernote, could you share more about the course? Because I think if people are looking to sort of dive into it.
Well, I'll get you to share a link, but it's a 10-part series called Evernote Made Easy. And it's basically walks you through the taking Evernote to the next level. And I hate that term, taken to the next level, but it is. But the key to it actually is the Evernote Quick Start. If you're just on the, so many people try Evernote and they don't succeed in using Evernote, or they don't use it to its full potential because they overcomplicate things at the beginning. I think you'd agree. You know, they try and build this huge infrastructure around Evernote because they see so much potential, and then they get analysis paralysis. And, you know, should I have this notebook or that notebook? Where am I going to put this? And they start building this tag infrastructure, and it's a nightmare. I teach in the very first lesson, I call it the Evernote Quick Start, and I tell people not to make any notebooks, just to create two very unique types of notes that really start you off on the right track. And we've had tremendous success in that. And that part of the course is free. So if you click on the link that Francesco shares with you, you can take the Evernote Quick Start, which is about a half an hour, take you about a half an hour to go through. And if you don't see the value of Evernote once you've gone through the Quick Start, Evernote's not for you. But if you do, then you can either continue on yourself, or you can upgrade and take our 10-part course, and we'll help you. We'll kind of accelerate the process for you.
Lovely jubbly. Brilliant. Steve, you're
going to share.
Lovely jubbly.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Lovely. Do you know that one?
What is a jubble?
I don't know what a jubble is. It's just a saying, like in England. Lovely jubbly.
Okay.
Do you not have any sayings, Steve, where, like in Canada?
Not quite like that.
No? Damn. I need to send over like a phrase book or something like that.
Yeah. Winner, chicken dinner. How's that?
Winner, chicken. Yeah, that works. Yeah.
Okay, there we go.
That translates well.
But while we're losing viewers by the score right now, maybe we should get to the content.
Yeah, please. Yeah. Yeah. You're going to share 5 things you love about Evernote. Features and all.
Ask me for a list. You put me on the spot, Francesco.
Okay, I did.
Well, I still think that the one thing that Evernote has done better than anybody, and nobody comes close as far as just like features that I love, is the Evernote Web Clipper. Nobody has done the Web Clipper better. And it's never better exemplified than when it breaks for some reason because there's a new operating system or a new browser update, and the Evernote Web Clipper breaks briefly, and the hue and cry from people who are so upset that it's not working, it tells you how much we rely on it. But I think a day doesn't go by that I don't clip something and just save it in Evernote. And it doesn't, and the way that I look at it is it's like this investment tool, because I look at Evernote as my digital bank account. And the more information that I have there that I can access when I need it in the future, the more equity, the more value there is. And the Evernote Web Clipper is probably the number one way that I get information into Evernote. So the Web Clipper is my number one tool. Everybody else has tried to do their own Web Clipper. Nobody's done it as elegantly as Evernote.
I agree with that, yeah. Like Notion's one is so basic compared to that one. It's always set the standard.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, Keep's got one. Everybody's got one, but it just doesn't do what Evernote's does. So that's number one. And I kind of am themed up here in the first, my favorite features are, I think, ways to get information into Evernote, because we know Evernote's so powerful in search. So, you know, getting access to your information is all great, but getting the information in effortlessly, that's a big deal. And next to the Evernote web clipper, the way that I get information into Evernote the most is when I've got my mobile phone with me through the camera on my phone. And I use the third-party Evernote app, or the Evernote app Scannable. It's not third-party, it's from Evernote. Rather than just using the native camera that's built into Evernote, although they both work exceptionally well. But I use that just as an information vacuum cleaner, constantly just pulling information and taking pictures of things and then storing them in Evernote so that I have access to them when I need them. So, and Scannable is very elegant. It's a great, I never use my flatbed scanner anymore. Even if I have documents to scan in for the bank or for any personal information, I use Scannable. And the thing that's nice about Scannable then, as opposed to using the Evernote camera, is Scannable lets you choose, once you've scanned a document in, whether or not you want to save it in Evernote, obviously, but also it makes it very easy for you to package it up and send it to people by email and to share that content in other places. So it makes it a one-step process, as opposed to if you use the Evernote camera, capture document, then you've got to go into Evernote and share the document from within Evernote. So I like, that's the reason that I like Scannable. So that's the second thing from Evernote that is my second favorite thing.
Yeah.
Number three? It's something brand new for me, and it's not really all that new, but it's this guy. Have you seen this guy, the Rocket Notebook?
I have. Yeah, I've seen it a couple of times shooting around the...
Have you tried one?
No, not yet. Like, I keep seeing it. I'm like, should I go for it?
You know? I love the Rocket Notebook. So here's the idea. With the Rocket Notebook was a Kickstarter project, and I first bought it in Kickstarter, and the first version of it was ridiculous.
Yeah.
It's an erasable notebook where you can write on it, and you use these pens from... who is it from? It's from Pilot. I think it's Pilot. Anyways, they're called Pilot. They're called Friction. FRIXION, and it's an erasable ink. But the first version of it, you used to have to stick in the microwave to erase it.
Really?
Which was just really. They had a microwavable version, which I thought was just bizarre. Although it did make you feel a little bit like James Bond as you erase the content.
Yeah.
New version, you can just take a damp cloth and you can wipe down the page. So it's fantastic from that perspective. It's a recyclable notebook. But the key to it is they've got, and I'll show you here because you can't see it in the bottom of the page, but they've got these, they've got this guide. I don't know if you can see this guide.
Little
icons.
Yes, yeah.
So what happens is at the bottom of each page, you've got these icons. You tick off the icons, and then they've got an app, of the Rocketbook app. You launch the Rocketbook app, you take a picture of the notebook, and based on the icon, it then sends it to the integration. And it'll send it to Dropbox, it'll send it to Google Drive, a specific notebook in Dropbox. It'll also send it to Evernote, and you can get very granular down to adding tags or which notebook you're going to be sending the information to. You can also send documents to Slack or straight to email, all of those things from the Rocketbook. So it's like it. Do you remember the what was the name of the notebook? The one that the fairly expensive notebook that you could scan into Evernote and they had little stickers that you stuck on it. Oh, it was Moleskine.
Yeah.
So they had one, but that was expensive, right? You know, because you had the stickers that were not here. You just tick off the bottom where you want it to go, the destination, use the camera. The camera is really slick, almost as good as Scannable as far as that goes. Automatically sees the screen and sends the information off in Evernote. I love this. For students, for so many different purposes, it's a really cool system. And I can do probably 90% of what I can do on my tablet using the Rocketbook. So that is, that's a winner, winner, chicken dinner.
Yeah, winner, winner, that's lovely jubbly, that is.
Yeah. Holy cow. Okay. Well, I got to find my notes because I wrote down my notes in it, and that's where I have my list of top five. Next up. So that's Rocketbook. The next thing is I love the feature built into Evernote where when we think about how Evernote works, the nature of the Evernote note, because it's a cloud-based service, is every note actually has a web address attached to it. And if you turn on sharing for that note, you basically have a web page that's created. I love using Evernote as a publishing tool for publishing content, sharing links. So when I'm working on projects with people, I give them a checklist. I share it in Evernote rather than using a Google Doc or other things. just because it's so efficient within Evernote to do that. So I love using Evernote as a publishing tool. As a matter of fact, the first version of the course that we delivered of Evernote Made Easy, the first three versions until the most current one, we delivered it as a series of shared notes. We never even had an LMS or a learning management tool that we hosted. We just, when you signed up, you got an email every morning with a link that said, here's today's lesson, and it was an Evernote note, and you saved that into your own notebook, and you had an Evernote textbook at the end. Evernote is a very powerful publishing platform that most people don't realize. Even if you don't have your own website, you can publish content to the web, share it in social media, and there's even tools that allow you to do blogging directly from Evernote. Create an Evernote notebook. If you save it as a tag for the blog, it'll publish it to a blog site for you. So I love Evernote's publishing capabilities as far as the sharing. I'm not talking about collaborative work, which is nice, but I'm talking about pure on publishing from Evernote. Hidden feature that most people never use, but I think is so powerful.
Definitely.
And the final one is, it's kind of lame, but it's the ubiquitous nature. It's the fact that everything is where it is when I need it and where I need it. And, you know, when you start using your mobile app and you just say, I need access to this note or that note, as you're going about and knowing as long as you have an internet connection that you have access to it, that is so powerful. And it reduces stress so much, because if you get into the habit of storing what your important content is in Evernote, then you always know where to put things. So you're not making decisions, how am I going to file this so I can find it again? Because you know you can find it again in Evernote. And secondly, it reduces stress when you need to find it, because you know it's there. And if it's not there, then you didn't save it, right? Yeah. So you're just getting in that habit of having one place to go for everything. That, to me, is something that the ubiquitous nature of Evernote would be my kind of fifth on my list of favorite features that Evernote, or favorite benefits of Evernote.
I love it. And
Charlie, I mean, I'm talking to Francesco. My dog is saying, Steve.
I saw a little bit of fur just crawl up, and I was like, yeah, that's Wally.
As soon as we're done here, he'll be going for his morning constitutional. So there we go.
Oh, bless him. Yeah, he always makes an appearance in the videos. I love it.
Farley does find his way up. Go lay down in your bed, and we'll go in a minute. Go lay down. Go lay down. You're just staring at me. He's just staring at me. He's just going, oh, Steve, really? Go lay down. It's okay, buddy.
He's wondering what this whole internet thing is.
Yeah. No, he knows.
Yeah, he knows. Yeah, he's seen it every day. Steve, those were awesome. Awesome list. And I'm going to check out the Rocketbook for sure. Because, that sounds really cool.
You'll like it. I mean, it sparks your imagination of things that you can do.
Yeah, definitely. Well, thanks so much for coming on. And where can everyone find you?
Everywhere at Dottotech. On YouTube, our channel's Dottotech, and then if you just visit dottotech.com, there's links to all of our information there.
I love it. Well, we'll chat soon, Steve. Yeah,
thank you very much, Francesco.
All right,
have fun storming the castle.